Hi, you are enjoying the holiday. I hope all is well. Now, in our last class, we looked at format of a former letter. The format of a former letter was what we looked at in our last class. But today, we are looking at writing a former letter. Now, before we look at writing a former letter, let us go back to what we did in the last class, which is the format of a former letter. Now, if you look at what I have here, this is a typical example of the format of a former letter. Just as I said, that if you are writing a former letter, the first thing that should be in your mind is the writer's address. That is your address. After that is the date. After the date is what? The recipient. That is the receiver of the letter. Who will receive the letter? Then followed by the receiver's what? Address. You can see this letter is going to the manager, is the recipient, and this is the address: Goodrich Company, plot 182, Ibrahim Road, Lagos. Followed by what? The salutation, which is what? Dear sir. And now, remember that we said also that the formal letter has what? The topic, that is what you want to talk about. Now, for this formal letter, you see the topic is incomplete supply of requested goods. That is what the writer wants to talk about in this letter. Now, after the writer must have talked about whatever he has to say, he will now come to the closing. And remember, I said that for formal letter, the closing should be what? Just faithfully. After you have done that, you will now what? You sign. Remember, I said that in this type of letter, you sign? Yes, you sign. Then you will now write what? Your name. Your name is going to include your surname. That is, you are writing your what? Full name. Now let's look at the letter we have on the board. You can see starting with the writer's address, the date, the recipient, and the recipient's address, our salutation, which is Jessa, and the topic, that is what the writer wants to talk about, which is incomplete supply of requested goods. Now let's look at the body of the letter proper. I write to inform you that the goods supplied to me on 20th June 2020 are incomplete as they are not up to what I requested for and also paid for. I requested and paid for 40 bags of rice, 30 gallons of groundnut oil, and 20 cartons of noodles. But what I received was 35 bags of rice, 20 gallons of groundnut oil, and 15 cartons of noodles. I will be glad if the remaining goods are forwarded to me on or before 30th June 2020. Thanks for your usual cooperation. Yours faithfully. The signature here, Audu Musa. Now you can see that this is a typical formal letter that we have on the board. With this, you should be able to write your own formal what? Letter. Now, this is what you will do for me to be sure that you can write yours. You are going to write any formal letter of your choice. You understand what I mean? Anyone. Like what I have here is a formal letter of my choice. I decided to write to this. I had to take the manager as my recipient and try to impute this address as my recipient address. So also, you think of any formal letter at all of your choice to write. Write it, direct it to whoever you want to direct it to, and forward it to my WhatsApp number, which is 080-3912-3251. I'll be expecting it